Welcome to the first traces tutorial in the world. Now that you're using traces, you've probably lived through stage one of the horror of setting up the Amiga or emulator. Now comes stage two, using traces itself. Let's do this. Please keep in mind, if you are using the emulator in turbo speed, it becomes faster and sometimes a bit hypersensitive to the keyboard input. This means you need to press the key a few times for it to trigger. We begin by hitting Shift P to add a plane. Now we right-click on the generated plane to select it. Then we hit S to scale the plane. We drag the cursor until we cover the grid floor, then left-click. If you can't scale it out enough in the first try, just left-click and hit S again to be able to scale some more. Then left-click. Now we hit Shift-S to add a sphere. Hit 1 on the number pad to enter front view. Then right-click on the sphere to select it. Hit G to grab and drag up until the sphere is resting on top of the plane. Then left-click to apply the position. Now hit V. This shows the current camera view boundary. Hit 3 on the number pad to enter side view. If you hit V again, you will see the camera view bounds again. We need to make sure the sphere is in the center of the camera view. So to do this, we hit O to grab the camera and drag it up a bit, and then left click to apply the position. Then hit V to see the camera view bounds. Repeat hitting O, then dragging it up until the sphere is in the middle of the camera view bounds. I am also hitting Render once in a while to see how it looks like so far. When I want to leave the render, I just left-click the render and it returns back to the viewport. Now we can't have a scene without a light source, or you'll get a dark, unusable render. To add a lamp, we hit Shift-L. Whoops! I forgot that I still have my sphere selected. We now right-click on the lamp to select it and drag it in front of the camera, and also a bit higher than the sphere, doing a test render. This is starting to look nice. Now I'm adjusting the camera again like before and test rendering until I am happy with the result. To enter top view, hit 7 on the number pad and use O to drag the camera to the side. Now we'll adjust the camera until we are happy with the result. To adjust the size of the sphere, first right-click on it, then hit S and drag the mouse outward. Then left-click to apply your desired scale. Now I'm adjusting the position of the camera. Again. Finally, we are finished with the adjustments. Now let's save the file. To save the file, you need to have an ADF floppy disk file in DF0 of your emulator. We will use this to save the file. Once you've put the ADF floppy disk file in, return to Traces and hit F2. The Save Scene window will open. Left-click on the DF0 button, then left-click on the bottom bar to write the file name. Remember to keep the name very short due to file name length limitations of traces. Then, after the file name, type .trace as the extension. Then hit OK. Now repeat, hitting F2 and navigating back to DF0 to now enter the same file name, but after the file name, type backup.trace, since traces sometimes saves a corrupt 3D scene. So it's best to have a couple of backups of the file, just in case. Now, hit OK. Let's add the materials now. Right-click the plane to select it. To enter the materials menu, hit F5. Left-click the circle to see the material preview. Then left-click Smooth. Now left-click the triangle to enter the texture panel. Now follow my material setup. Right-click the lamp to select it. Now left-click on the lamp settings. Select Sun. Beautiful render, isn't it? We're not done yet, though. Now go into Side View and hit R to rotate the lamp, so it's pointing at the sphere. Hit Shift L to add another lamp. Right-click the sphere to select it, and then enter the materials panel using F5. Now follow my material setup again. Now set up the rendering options like me. Save the file again, but now call it something different. Then make a backup of the different file and hit render. Once the render is complete, left-click on it, and when back in the viewport, hit F3 to enter the Save Image window. Left-click on DF0 and enter the file name you would like, and then end it with .iff, as that is the image format Traces uses. To get the render out, simply download ADF Opus. The link is in the description. Once you get the .iff image out, you need to convert it to a normal modern image format. To do this, simply use the online converter in the description or use XNView MP if you would like to do it offline. If you ever want to open the Traces 3D scene again, simply hit F1, left click on DF0, left click on the Traces file, and then left click the OK button. And that's it! Congratulations! You have successfully created your first ever Traces 3D render. Thanks for watching and have an awesome day.